five games into his highly anticipated senior season, Purdue quarterback Drew Brees' team was floundering at 3-2. And the hopes of Brees winning Purdue's first-ever Heisman Trophy were fading as well. The next opponent on the Boilermakers' schedule was sixth-ranked Michigan, who visited West Lafayette, Indiana on October the 7th, 2000.
I don't think there was any doubt in anyone's mind of going into the season that we were going to be Big Ten champs at the end of the season. Even when we were sitting at one point in time 3-2, I still believe everybody on the team believed that we were going to be Big Ten champions.
We had lost to Penn State and to Notre Dame prior to that. So it was a little disappointing to be 3-2 at that time because, you know, going into, obviously, it was our senior year. It was one of those things where the mentality was a must-win mentality.
Wolverine quarterback Drew Henson had led Michigan to a 4-1 start with a strong passing attack. But the key player for the Wolverines on offense was their senior running back, the A-Train, Anthony Thomas.
He was probably more of your prototypical-looking running back. Very strong. Had good speed, good breakaway speed. You know, he was just kind of your all-around back. He could do everything.
These two high-powered offenses would not disappoint the capacity crowd at Ross-Ade Stadium in a slugfest that would go down to the wire.
It was a very good Michigan football team. We were a really good football team. We felt like it was...
Justin Fargus and Walter Cross back deep for the Wolverines. There's Justin, who will see some work in the defensive backfield today. And he'll begin the day coming out for the end zone. 15, smashed down just short of the 20-yard line. And Drew Henson, who has had two remarkable fourth quarters in the last 2 weeks for Michigan against Illinois and the Badgers a week ago. 6 of 11 for 143 yards and two touchdowns, including the dramatic game winner to David Terrell against the Badgers last weekend. So Henson and the Wolverines pour onto the field for their first play. Anthony Thomas, number 32, is a good bet to be involved in some manner. The Akeli behind SQ, the fullback. And Thomas motors for a first down as we take a look at our Chili's starting lineup. An outstanding offensive line. Jeff Backus over there on the left side and tackle. 42 consecutive starts for Jeff, who's right next to Steve Hutchinson. And Terrell with that catch a week ago. Now he's got a touchdown pass in six straight games. That includes the Orange Bowl win over Alabama. Askew leads the way for the A-Train. And let me tell you, Askew is a very dangerous receiver when they slide him out into the pass pattern. On a first and 10 for the Wolverines, Henson's quick drop, and he pops into Marquise Walker's hand. Walker coming off a career day, a 5-yard gain against this Boilermaker defense. Matt Mitrone, number 98, is their best defensive lineman. 7 tackles for a loss already this year. The linebackers will be under enormous pressure here this afternoon because Landon Johnson is nicked, and we're not sure how much, if any, he will be able to play today. And the small fella is Clompton, nicknamed the Munchkin. Play action, roll right, Tyron Seymour, wide open, first down, and out to the 48-yard line. And Gary Seymour was rolling wide open that time.
A little bit of the bootleg action that Michigan made famous in their run to the national championship with Brian Greasy. Action going this way, hold there, coming out. Here comes Henson on the move. And then once he gets it to his tight end, Seymour turns up field. Gets a little bit of a shoe duster tackle from Turner. There, a little shoe duster, nothing but air right there. And that got the first down.
That allowed him to make a gain of 18 yards on that pass play. Terrell is off to Henson's right on this first down near midfield for the Wolverines. Their opening drive of the game. Another short drop. Marquise Walker, they're playing off. So he's made his second receiver. interception, and he crosses midfield for a gain of three. Clopton makes the stop.
And there's the game plan being exploited already by Michigan, trying to get the ball to the big Michigan receivers against the smallish corners for Purdue. Clopton, as you mentioned, goes about 5 7.
He was asked if he likes that nickname, the Munchkin. He says, don't care as long as you're playing it. So Askew, the lone running back. It's his sideline. Marquise Walker reaches up and grabs it at the 35. A slick catch as he appeared to be falling, and still he makes a 14-yard gain.
Last week, Michigan, I think, looked at themselves, threw the ball on first down 10 straight times. In this game, I think you look at Drew Brees, figure he's going to put some points on the board and say, let's try to throw the ball early in this football game. He's got Junior's phone number now.
If he's got Derek's, he can congratulate the Yankees on it, putting in over the A's last night to stay. First down, here comes Thomas. Bangs for about 6 yards. Crosses into the red zone. So far, it has been this Michigan offense out-muscling Purdue's defense. That veteran offensive line, except for that one penalty against them, they have been just picture perfect. Vincent's had time. He has put Walker into the game. He still always has the dangerous David Terrell. He's completed his first 5 passes for 45 yards, most of them on short drops. The A-train behind Askew. First down, and he throws his way to the 7.
There it is. They're running the Wisconsin offense, Brent, right now, and taking it right to the quick but smaller Purdue defense. There it is. Tight end's going to come right up. Here comes another tight end right to the outside. Power football by Michigan coming outside. Everybody get someone. Just head up and run. Stick and run. That's good blocking by that offensive line. This was the fear that Brock's back had coming into this game.
Helps to have this turf here in Purdue. He had trouble making that cut last week. And this time he cannot get away from the defense as he tries to take it back up to the middle. And Gardner right there, bringing him down inside the 10-yard line.
If you look at Anthony Thomas's big games, they've all been on the road. I think he's more comfortable running on a faster track. He has good games on the turf, and he has good game here. Looks like he's running very well on this quicker surface.
And Bellamy will be sliding to the left. Now you're coming in motion, and that should help Terrell on the right side, but he's looking to rock it down. Touchdown! Marquise Walker on a hook slam after they motioned in the other direction.
This is the offense that Michigan fans were wondering where it's at. A balanced, run hard, be physical, and use your wide receivers. Look at this, playing this far off to the outside, just a quick slant. This was pitch and catch, a great read, and a perfect throw right low into the numbers.
Jeff Delvern. And the shorter of the field goals. Hayden is going to be the punter.
Michigan 7, Purdue 9.
Coming.
Download your free diagnosis today at mycleanpc.com.
Eric Wilson will be in the starting lineup today. Oakley said he would play, but they didn't tell us that he was going to play from the very beginning. Shotgun look, inside hand off low. And the Wolverines smack him at the 15. Now, Purdue's first drives this season. Let's go back and compare them in 98 and 99, where they misfired. But look at this year through 5 games, Gary. They haven't done a thing.
Yeah, that has been a big concern. Both Drew Brees, Jim Chaney, and Joe Tiller said we must get off fast. And they just watched Drew Henson run it down the field. It's even more important.
Makes his presence felt right away. He's credited with that tackle. On first down. Toss play. Here's Sutherland lined up in the backfield. And Michigan's great speed ready for it. James Whitley runs him down. Let's take a look at our Chili's lineup for Purdue. The offensive line, a veteran group, 121 career starts amongst that group right there. Ton of wide receivers in this all-out tiller attack. Sutherland lined up at tailback. Already Lowe has carried the ball once.
Michigan comes in with a dime pack.
Terry Stratton makes the first down for Purdue. We're going to get an update from Terry Gannon back in New York. Terry, nice to have you with us today.
8 to 9 yards.
All right, Terry, it looks like a little hostile weather down there, too. Score. Well, the Boilermakers have their first down on an opening drive of the season. That's hard to believe. Short group Greens comes back. Middle Sutherland's got it. And quickly, they put together first downs out to the Purdue 41-yard line. Larry Foote to make the tackle. We check in on that defense with Eric Wilson already on the field and making his presence felt. Linebackers will come and go depending on the situation. Larry Foote made that tackle. And, of course, in that defensive backfield, Williams, Lesur, Fargus, and now Drake also in on the dime package. Howard with an interception in the end zone against Brooks Bollinger of Wisconsin. And also on the final play of the game. So he had two picks last week. And now Drew Brees with a first down at the Boilermakers 41. Play fake by his time. Got a wide open man, and he can't hang on. Keith Dawson, I'll tell you, the Boilermaker receivers, they have dropped a lot of passes on Drew Brees.
Last year in this game, 13 dropped passes and a loss at Michigan. It was a rainy day, but, you know, Brett, to have 13 dropped passes and complete 20, that means you're pretty accurate.
Now Joe Tiller trying to keep this opening drive going here against the Wolverines. They're down a touchdown already. Third down for Brees. That is first down. John Standifer at the 43-yard line. Second down and one. Inside handoff, nothing good as the Wolverines eat the play up. College football on ABC Sports brought to you by Ford F-Series. The best-selling trucks are built Ford tough. Dell, providing the infrastructure to power your e-business. National Car Rentals, so what are you waiting for? Let's go. And Budweiser, with the crisp, clean, refreshing taste you'll find in no other beer. So Gary and Brent in their first disagreement of the day. I say out of bounds is out of bounds, whether it comes off the line or not.
I'm going to win another one, folks.
I think that what LaPatina said, if it's deflected by the defensive team, it's legal to come back in bounds, which is what he did. He didn't come back in bounds.
No, let's give him something else. I'm 1-0. I know I'm 1-0. No game solutions for Purdue in this game. They must get better in first down. 4 yards or more. They were awful against Penn State that last week. And as Brent said before, pitch and catch. Make it easy. Short, controlled ball passes against this Michigan defense. Michigan needs to manhandle the receivers. Don't try to stop Brees. Stop the receivers.
There's first down. Brees down at the 30-yard line. First down. First down and goal from the 9-yard line for Brees and Purdue on their opening drive. Well, going nowhere because Munichek was hanging on.
Michigan's defense picked up. Jake Freisinger hurt. Mumashek has come back in. Had a good game last week against Wisconsin. Now they have Eric Wilson, number 92, Rumshin. Here's his rump. Coming off the block, making the play. And this is a pretty veteran offensive line, as you mentioned, for Purdue. They've been through the wars. They got a four-year starter and 2 3-year starters on their offensive line.
Ricky!
Ricky! Oh, at the 7-yard line.
No, no help on all three receivers out here. He's going to shift to main man, bring the tight end to help block.
Interceptions against Wisconsin last Saturday.
First bad ball that Drew Brees threw in this game. You need to get that down there near the goal line, near the body of the slanting receiver like Henson threw it to Walker a minute ago. That was behind.
Look at how hot these two quarterbacks are. Henson perfect in his first drive. Brees 6 of 8 for 58 yards. All he locks is the touchdown, and it would equal Henson's first drive. Let the shootout begin here. Now on third and goal. Brees waits back in the end zone. Through the receiver's hands, they dropped another one. A.T. Simpson.
And you saw Drew Brees grab his head afterward. Through this ball, Drew Brees did a great job of staying with the route, being comfortable in the pocket. Zings it just slightly behind. Come on. That has to be frustrating for a team that's in a must-win situation. Michigan busts in the secondary, and another drop ball for the Boilermakers.
So Travis Gersh will attempt a field goal at 24 yards. And Purdue is on the board. But instead of the touchdown, they settle for the field goal because another drop pass. Perfect. 7 of 7 for 58 yards and that touchdown on the first drive.
Very smartly going to what the Michigan people perceive as a mismatch. The size of the Michigan receiver, some of the biggest receivers in college football Michigan has against a smallish corner. Thought there was right there on that last play, but a perfect throw.
And David Terrell has not caught one of the 7 completions yet. In fact, he's off on the sideline right now. On second down, he's still perfect as he hits the fullback Askew out to the 42-yard line. And Gilbert Gardner, the Purdue defender. Yeah, that was some piece of fabric or lack of fabric. 32. Here's the hand and Thomas. First down, Michigan. Now, it was blown dead before that football came out. That's scrum. Then Lloyd saying, come on, it was a face mask. You could see his body language over there. So Drew Henson, perfect in the first quarter. With a first and 10 for the Wolverine 45 off a pump fake. What's the big man? Incomplete as the safety rotated over was Ralph Turner, and it was double coverage at the end of that attempt.
Chris Clopton that time, they tried to go slant. Remember, they were hitting the slants in front of them. This time, that slant and out that time. And Chris tries to grab a hold at the end because he knows he's beat. Watch him come back and says, I'm in trouble here. He reaches out his arm and tries to get in there, but the ball was slightly overthrown. Nice call. Nice first down call to take advantage of.
Now Walter Cross is the running back behind Henson for the Wolverines. Marquise Davis crosses first point, breaks a tackle, crosses midfield. Powerful run out of bounds at the 34-yard line. Walter Cross. Up that dish here later this afternoon. The Rod sure wants to see some of that Clemson North Carolina State game along with the Badgers and the Buckeyes. Early game Saturday afternoon. Play fake Askew. Hits and roll. Hit on the release. Got Seymour. Seymour to the 7-yard line. And Henson showing his courage that time. Knew he was going to take a lick
And he did. He showed courage, that's for sure. He showed rare ability to readjust his sights and just flick the ball out to his third receiver. A little bootleg that time. We see guys crossing here, but watch Henson just at the last second say, nobody downfield. He wanted to go right here. He was covered, and he just flicks the ball to the outside to his number two man. That was beautiful.
Coach, I think it's amazing to see that all the hype about this young man was about three tight ends, Eric Russell, in receiver, and Chapman. And here's Thomas to the 3 yard line. So the power package on the field for the Wolverines is only their second drive of the game. They dominated statistically, and they have kept the clock moving in their favor. They have kept the ball out of Drew Brees' hands, except for once here today. And because of a drop pass, the Boilermakers settled for a field goal. Michigan's having it their way right now. Jason Lozell. He's in on that tackle with a lot of help from his friends down there.
Lozell is playing for the injured Landon Johnson. Rocks back, the defensive coordinator from Purdue, talks very highly of Landon Johnson. Lozell is a returning starter from last year. See him blitz inside that time. And Michigan fullback without good one time.
Coming up next on the Big Ten's Greatest Game. Keeps the Purdue defender off balance by throwing on first down.
That's what the author is talking about.
Mark Kirsten has the
doesn't go well on it.
Inside the 20. Figures he has, huh? Three interceptions in the last two games for Michigan.
Purdue fans to understand, and Michigan fans to believe that they got a break here. Howard come behind. Let's see if this ball hit the ground. Comes out.
He goes to the back of the bump. And the pass was a little bit underthrown on that as Rickard was bumping Terrell down the field.
And it was underthrown because it was a safety blitz. Swigart this time is coming from the safety spot. Henson gets rid of it. You see the matchup with Woodard in there. Woodard turns around and finds the ball, but can't catch it. But the reason Henson threw the ball short is because the safety was right in his face.
Terrell was given as much as he was given.
Oh, yeah.
The NFL scouts are going to like that. A big physical receiver and run that.
They're using, and that's all that David Terrell said. Just give me a chance to make plays. They're way off on
the middle. And it's going down. Big for the first down. We'll cut across midfield.
Then you do some blocking, and now the big guy way up top right here, David Terrell, gets a big block right there. Another receiver right there. That springs it for the touchdown.
Wow, is that nice?
The Patriots have won.
I'll tell you something, ladies and gentlemen. The A-Train that time was an express. 21-3 Michigan.
Information and this free $50 savings card. Call now.
First down and 10. Perfect breeze. Underneath, and he picks up his
great tight pass
end.
Complete to Tim Stratton
again. So Tim Stratton today with three receptions for 30 yards, and he's the leading receiver. The ball near midfield. Second down and seven. Across the 45-yard line. You know, Gary, what's interesting, if we take a look at the Tiller records for years and drives on first downs, you know, I've always had the theory that the longer an unorthodox offense is in a conference, the better it's going to be defended because defensive coordinators have more time. They've played against it. They can break down the tapes of what Joe Tiller has done. They know what his tendencies are. And I suppose that makes the performance of the St. Louis Rams even more spectacular, having said something like that. And my goodness, no one can get that offense out. But definitely Purdue's offense is being defended pretty well and better by teams around the Big Ten right now.
And the tight end means he's going to throw a man-to-man route. That's a man-to-man tight end for Mark.
First down. Just inside the 30-yard line. Vinny Sutherland, as much as a go-to receiver as anybody on this Purdue team, but 15 more yards.
And what you were mentioning about the defense is getting ready to stop this offense, the more they've seen it, you can see another thing emerging is these Purdue has not beat the big guys in this conference, and neither has Purdue. 0-7 against Penn State, Ohio State, Wisconsin. Wisconsin and Michigan. That's another question about whether this is an offensive
Love cannot be free because Rumashek made a great defensive effort. Well, old Drew likes to impersonate the comedian. Favorite movie is Braveheart, which he needs here today. And a size 14 shoe.
I love that size 14 shoe. Yeah, and he has great footwork for as big as he is.
Does he shop up in Madison? Just kidding, Drew. Just kidding. At the 25-yard line.
Where that dam is going to score it.
Isn't that the truth? He's back there.
Oh, he's going to get the blitz, look. See, he's going to come right under there.
Here he comes. Sutherland, and it covers the defensive back. Slips. Sutherland into the end zone.
Michigan would add a fourth touchdown on their last possession of the first half and take a 28-10 lead into the break, which put pressure on the Purdue offense going into the second half.
The psyche of this group.
Looking for a second half. Now they're going to split with Winston.
Donald Winston, the block area.
We take a look at the Morgan Stanley Dean Witter halftime stats here.
Well, one other thing that stands out of this game is no punts. Not a punt in this football game.
They did solve that problem.
That problem is solved. eight for Michigan in third down. Look at that, not bad. 6 for 7.
Second down, one.
Amazing.
But it could really lift Purdue's spirits and chances for a quick touchdown as well.
Watch out!
And there is a Hobson. Fine defensive play by Victor Hobson, the sophomore linebacker.
Victor Hobson had a great ball game when he would be more prominently featured against a Wisconsin attack running the ball. He was all over the football field. Against this thing, you see him running off the field all the time. He's going to not even have to shower after this game.
Hey, Jimmy Herman, situation substitution for Michigan defensively here today. Third down and two for the first down with Breeze lining up five wide receivers. Here's the outside blitz, steps away, hits Sutherland for the first down.
Pretty easy. If you got man-to-man across the field, Drew Brees is going to his most comfortable receiver. I'm not going to yet label Sutherland as a go-to receiver because he can't get enough snaps in the game. Vinny kind of wears out as the game goes on. Jim Shaney told us yesterday, just can't play this guy 70 snaps. He's more of a 40 snap.
Gary, who's the fastest of the Purdue wide?
Vinny Sutherland, yeah. Vinny is.
Three wide here. James Whitley, but it's a 29-yard run for Montrell Lowe.
Right up the middle of the defense. Rumshick, let's see what happens if he gets whipped by somebody, one of his own guys. Well, it's kind of hard to figure out. He just kind of dove and landed on his own knee there, didn't it?
You're right back in this ball game, folks, with this offense. If they could find a way to stop, who hits it?
You really didn't get Gene Cady to run that Big Ten defense that he always runs out there for that little defense.
He's going to running back football man. Basketball coaches just back from Australia on the task force. The Cedric Brown comes in, and Cedric is belted out of bounds at the 26. Gary, it looks like Purdue has decided to come to run against this situation substitution, at least so far.
Yeah, they're going to try to take some clock, but when you're down 28 to 10, you can't do too much. Brent, you know, a lot of people think this offense is a mad bomber offense, but if you look, 36 of Drew Brees' touchdown passes have been inside the 10-yard line. This is a ball control offense, and that's what you're going to see Purdue try to do in the second half.
Second down. Brees popped in and got the tight end again for the first down. And number 89, Timmy Stratton, and makes another catch. And he has four catches for 37 yards. Sutherland, the leading receiver, 5 for 74.
Very nice. Drew Brees again checking out the defense. He sees two deep safeties that time. He says, I'll go to my tight end over the middle. One free safety. He knows it's more man-to-man. All the things that a quarterback has to do when he breaks the huddle. Check the play clock, safeties, find out if the cornerbacks are playing man. They left to right, have a routine, and then snap the ball. Each snap, the quarterback has to go through a progression. And just like the golfer, Brent, he has to do it every time the same way so the defense can't read him.
And it was Cedric Brown again with his second carry, and Petrozello making the stop. Jack Alute sends up word from the field that Romashek suffered a stinger, and Michigan medical staff evaluating that to see whether or not he can return. Second down and eight. Purdue deploys five wide receivers. They bring Sutherland in motion on that end around play that they like, and Sutherland's speed carries him inside the 10, out of bounds for a Purdue first down. Dwayne Patman, the free safety there.
I think Joe Tilley did a great job with his football team at halftime and said, let's not try to score 18 points in one drive. Let's go down and get points in every drive and take our chances. Let's hold the ball, let's be patient on offense, and let's see what happens towards the end of the game. They won't get back in. Perfect coach.
Here's the first and goal. Working to the short side, and the receiver slipped on the reception. Stratton went down after making the catch. Had he been able to turn and square, maybe, but just maybe. Lemeshek returns, so that's good news for Michigan and its fans. Very fine game today. Second down and goal at the 2-yard line. Now, Drew Brees will frequently run a quarterback draw. He lines up under center. They'll toss this. It is for the flag. Bunches for it. He is out at the line. Looked like he had the flag.
That's so too.
Must have been out just before he made contact with Steve Ennis, 44.
Eric Brackens had a shot at Ennis that time. Kind of took a bad angle for the tackle. He got the fire.
Ennis is looking for the delayed delay.
This is an early flag. There's no one to do it. He wants to tell him to throw a red flag on his thing.
Can you get a guy for celebration when he doesn't score? There he is. No doubt. He made sure that time.
I think you're seeing why Lloyd Clark opened up the offense against Purdue. He knew he needed a lot of points against this offense. Just a root amount of play, Ennis goes over the top. And you know, I think that's a perfect game plan. If you're, you know, someone comes out and says, let's take our time and score. But Lloyd Clark looked ahead. He knew his defense. defense couldn't just shut him down. So he says, we're going to come out and not wait to the second half for this game.
So throw this drive back. Only 75 yards. Yeah. Everything else been 80
looks
yards.
Looks like Purdue's going to go for two on this one.
This is a minnow drive. Purdue will take it.
Try to make it a 10
point. Go for two here. Brandon Williams made the defensive play for the Wolverines on Seth Morales. I actually thought Purdue's right tackle moved too quickly, but there was no flag.
Didn't see it. I was watching the receivers, Brent, but he had A.T. Simpson. I watched some practices. One guy goes in motion to it here. But watch Simpson, the second guy on the delayed slant. He's wide open. Goes to the first receiver, then there's the second receiver looking wide open.
They got a tough break. They actually could have used the better than call. They're going to take another crack. We got timeout. Second half. Travis Dorsch. And Cross from the 2 yard line. And he is out of bounds at about the 23 yard line. Folks, how do you improve on this? And Gary, I'm not sure that I have ever seen anything quite like this.
No, I haven't either. That's, Ali's impressive. I don't know if I've ever seen a first half where a quarterback had such a perfect game as defense had either. That's how you get those drives.
Well, let's see what they come up with, what wrinkles that they might have against him. Brock Spack is a fine defensive coordinator, and Purdue has played well defensively, except for the first half against Michigan. And so Brock has got to come up with some wrinkles now. He's got to get some heat on this, and he knows that. Drew is 19 of 23 for 194. The defensive tackle makes the stop.
Not only did they run all directions in the first half, not only did they complete a lot of passes, they did it all over the field. Every little area of the field has been attacked beautifully in this charge. And that's what, when you look back as a quarterback and as a play caller, as offensive coordinator Stan Parrish, he says, we're attacking the defense perfectly.
Second and 10, and they split Anthony Thomas out of the backfield as a wide receiver. They're going to throw it to him right away. So a screen from Anthony. And Thomas to the 32-yard line. Nicely designed play there, Gary.
Very safe play, much like the screen pass that started off the last touchdown drive. To ask you, this is very simple. No bump and run by the Purdue outside players. That little slip screen to the outside. You get the ball in the hands of your playmaker. That seems to be the theme of the Michigan offense.
You know, our fellow sounds are front, led by Bob Goodrich and Larry Cam, are giving us some excellent views of this action at Drew Hinsinger today. Third down and a yard to go. All our cameramen into the game. And good defense that time. And Purdue defensive front was ready here in a short yardage play. Matt Mitrone, number 98, was right there. Well, Gary, you were just talking about head coach Lloyd Carr and his philosophy, and here's what he told you.
Within what you believe, take the players and get the ball to your playmakers. From an offensive standpoint and a defensive standpoint, do what your players do best.
Yeah, and nobody does it quite as well in big games as Lloyd Carr.
No, that's exactly right. And he seems to have a good formula with his kids. But, you know, it's easy to grab playmakers in this offense because he's got a lot of them. It's hard not to go to a playmaker in this offense.
How about this stat? 9 of 9 on third down conversions. How good is that for an offense?
As well as Purdue has moved the ball. Remember, they have not punted in this game either. It'll be demoralizing if Michigan runs it down on them again and scores. This may be the key drive of the football.
Hinsinger in trouble, spins, fires, almost completed the pass to Terrell after spinning out of a defender.
And again, fans of football, of college football, of great players to watch. This is a guy that's playing about 70% right now on his right angle. He does not push off the way I remember him pushing off to throw the ball, but you can see the great footwork he has in the pocket. It is Elway-esque.
Second down and 10. Good protection. And short of the first down to the 41, and that's number 19, Ronald Bellamy. So Ronald Bellamy's first catch here.
Bellamy, another big play guy who hasn't gotten the ball much. What we saw last week, he had two reverses against Wisconsin. He has great speed. But that ball was thrown very aggressively by Drew Henson. There wasn't much of an opening, and Bellamy just went up and snatched it. And this was not an easy catch. Bellamy over the slot. He's only about 10 yards away. And he just grabbed that ball.
Third and two, and both fullbacks are in, but before the snap. The play clock.
I think he jumped at the end of the line of scrimmage that time. Billy Seymour just lurched forward.
Prior to the snap.
Yep.
Dead ball. False start. Offense.
Very cleanly played game. Not a lot of penalties in this game. But
so Michigan leads Purdue 28-16. With Gary Danielson and Jack O'Reilly. I'm Brett Musburger. Key Big Ten match. Michigan, unbeaten in the conference, suffered one defeat at the hands of UCLA out of the conference. Purdue beaten last week by Penn State, and they're trying to rally now. Drew Henson is 21 of 26 as he goes to fire for the 27th time, incomplete. He's thrown for 212 yards and three touchdowns, and folks have just played this in time for something we haven't seen all day. And that's a punt.
First punt of the game.
Hayden Epstein trots onto the field to punt for the Wolverines. And Vinny Sutherland, who has scored one of Purdue's two touchdowns, is back deep, trying to ignite a fire. After the halftime intermission, Purdue took the ball, drove down the field for a touchdown, and missed the two-point conversion. Off the side of the foot, takes a Michigan roll, and they'll take it. Inside the 20-yard line.
Coming up next on the Big Ten's Greatest Game.
The field slips through. Touchdown, Purdue! Trails by 12 points right now when he yanked his headset off. He appears to have damaged it a little bit, so he's recovering it, so he can throw his assistant coaches, pull down linemen. They fake the end around. Cedric Brown out to the 27-yard line.
So patient Drew Brees is. And guys looking for the home run. That was a play looking for a home run ball. It wasn't there. He read his keys. He remembered what he looked at in film. He didn't get the look. So he just dumped it off and he's going to try to move the chains. All you young quarterbacks out there, the big play will happen. Watch these two guys taking the little ball.
Hit on the
run all the way that time.
And for you folks who joined us, let me show you two plays that Purdue would dearly love to have back. In the first half, on their opening drive, they drove for what would have been a touchdown, but the pass is dropped in the back of the end zone. They settle for three. Then a bad call. They gave Michigan the ball on an interception at the goal line. And Howard obviously did not have control, but Michigan took it and marched for another touchdown. Now it's first and 10 here for Purdue. Drew Brees sprinting to the left. Drops it off to Sutherland, and Sutherland is out. And you just can sense a different rhythm with this Purdue team this half, Gary.
Brent, I think they went in at halftime and said, listen, they haven't stopped us. Come on, we're beating ourselves. We can move the ball on these guys if we're just patient. Let's just try to make first downs, and let's not try to do everything in the first half. In the first drive, excuse me. Look at the pass chart for Drew Brees. Look at how accurate this guy is. Remember, two of them have been dropped. He is amazingly accurate.
Second down and two. Victor Hobson, who made the defensive play on Cedric Brown. Let us check in with Jack Aru. Jack?
Gary, you talk about the changes that are made at halftime. One of the things that Jim Chaney, the offensive coordinator, loves to do
was say, get a philosophical feel for his opponent's defense. Then he's got narrowed down 100 plays to maybe 20 to 25. And then he says, at halftime is when we make our big adjustments. Looks like, as you said, they've done a good job.
Here's third and five after the defensive play by Hobson. Big play in the drive. Here's with time. Right at the first down mark. He's going to get the spot. First down, Purdue.
The theme of stopping Drew Brees is mug the receiver and get a hand in the face of Drew Brees. Watch how long he has to throw this ball. He's just going to stand there, no pass rush at all. Wait and wait and wait and wait for someone to get across that first down line and throw it. He's too accurate to do that on third and five. Got to get a hand in his face.
And the 46 and Dave Petrozello was asked about their attitude after Brees is successful. What do you do?
Patience. You know, this team is just one that you have to keep going. You got to keep going. You can't start letting his big playmaking ability get you down. You know, and going out there and just having the attitude of not quitting and keep going.
Well, here they are on second and six. Incomplete. Trying to thread the needle. Whitley with good coverage on the wide man. It was Keith Dawson on the sideline. That was a big play for the Wolverines right now. And they switch five different players. Jimmy Herman, now a sixth man.
Fresh bodies.
Rotated, keeping fresh troops on the field, man.
Remember last time, no pressure on the quarterback. This time, let's see if Jim Herman tries to change it up and put pressure by rushing more than three.
Third down and six. Brees waits middle, got it, first down. John Standiford to the 41-yard line.
Can't really fault Jimmy Herman. Remember, he brought the safety blitz on the touchdown to Sutherland. Now he rushes three guys, and Brees picks it apart. Accuracy from a quarterback is key, and both of these quarterbacks are showing that if you get what you look at, how good an offense can be. No pass rush. The freshman cuts across the middle. Not very good coverage by Michigan that time. Poor technique in your man coverage, and you give him a first down.
13-yard gain to the Wolverine 41.
Michigan's DBs could be wearing down.
There's that inside lineup, Cedric Brown. He marches to the 36-yard line, and Hobson again. Well, we go back historically, and you can see how Brees measures up with Chuck Long, who's a great Iowa Hawkeye quarterback. 75 touchdown passes now with that one in the first half to Vinnie Sutherland. Broke the tie with Long. You see the total offense ahead of him. And closing in on pass yards. So he'll hold the conference and the Purdue passing records when his fabulous career is finally over here at the end of the season. Brees has got it. On a quarterback keeper, not much out of it because Whitley read it well, and number five quickly moved to the attack.
On that play, Drew Brees has the option of keeping that ball on his own. The rest of the offense didn't even know that time he was going to keep it. 20-25.
He's 20-25. Henson is 21-27. Folks, we have had the gunfight at the OK Corral in between these two here today.
You know what, Brent, the fire alarm kept us up awake last night over at the hotel. We stayed with Michigan Valley, and Jimmy Herman slept anyway.
Third down and three. Vincent Brees fires complete to the 25-yard line.
Man, first big-time catch. That's the first one Brees kind of threw. Had to pull the string on it. And his senior receiver bailed him out this time. A little bit of pressure up front. Brees sidesteps it to the outside as he goes right past Eric Wilson that time. Throws it a little low. And Sutherland comes back and picks it up.
Andre Henderson is split out to the left for Brees. And a play fake. He's going to run again to the right. Got it out. 15 out of bounds. Sports is brought to you by the new 2001 Pontiac Bonneville, luxury with attitude. Morgan Stanley, Gene Winter, move your money, get well connected. Dr. Pepper and your local Dr. Pepper bottler, Dr. Pepper makes the world taste better. And BASF, we don't make a lot of the products you buy, we make a lot of the products you buy better.
Brent, us along with a lot of people up in the press box at halftime were talking about Michigan as being maybe the best team in the country. I don't know if their defense is the best team in the country, but this is a young defense, a lot of injuries.
Second down and two after the Breeze run. And Lowe back on the field, slips through. Touchdown, Purdue! They score in the first two possessions of the second half.
To a guy you can't hardly even see behind that senior offensive line, and they poke it into the end zone to make it 28-24.
Travis Bush adds the extra point. So now Lowe is carried 14 times for 100 yards and this 16-yard touchdown. Time out.
Talking to his defense a couple of series ago. Roxback took his defense just before they went back on the field and reminded them that they need to keep it very simple. He said quite explicitly, remember, it's one series, series by series. And he said, you know what? Even more so, let's just keep it play by play.
I think the coaches know that they're involved in one that could go to the last series. When you watch Carl on one side, and the coordinators for Purdue on the other, you just get the feeling of the intensity building in this game. Here comes Thomas.
Really interesting, Ben. Both of the head coaches, Lloyd Carr and Joe Tiller, got their roots as defensive coordinators in college football. You spread them out, you isolate them, you match it up very much like the NFL, and the influence of the NFL has been huge on college football.
Walker and Terrell are off to the right. And Henson looks in that direction, and he's got Terrell. Terrell brought down from behind at the 43 by Woodyard.
So you can, Lloyd Carr talking to his guys, Brock Spack talking to his guys. Come on, let's play hard. What can you do, though? When you got a matchup and timing like this, Henson goes back. Look at the timing. Thrown before he breaks. Decent coverage. What are you going to do about that? The only way to do it is like they do in the big leagues, Brent. You got to get to the quarterback.
Exactly. 17-yard gain on that pass completion, and now Henson has thrown for 232 yards. Split back look. Armstrong in the game is the fullback. He'll lead the A-train Thomas.
Thomas, the ball carrier.
37-yard line. And Adele making the stop.
And Odom.
So a reminder that at the end of the game, we'll select a Chevrolet player of the game from each team. Chevrolet makes a $1,000 contribution. Deitch University General Scholarship Fund. Do we do it now or do we do it later?
To the 37.
It's and Terrell limped off to the side after that completion. So he's out of the game right now on second and four. Seymour and Chapwood, the Wolverines, the two tight ends. Looks like a blitz off the corner. They blitz the win, and Thomas is short on the first down. Joe Odom was in on the snap down there.
The situation for Michigan and their field goal kicking. Remember, they've only been 3 for 9 this season. And then being on the 32-yard line, right if they're in four-down territory, no matter what, they've got 2 yards to make, or 2 downs here to make a first down.
Zachary, what's up with Terrell? We see he's coming out. We know he's coming back in the game, my friend. What happened?
Yeah, but what the media could be concerned about is the reason he came out. He's starting to cramp up. It's kind of cold, and I'll tell you what, you start to cramp now.
Third down. They ran it. Purdue ate the play up. Thomas never had a chance. They stormed the walls, the Boilermakers did.
Now they have to play, don't they?
Jason Rozelle makes another big play for Purdue.
Very interesting decision here by Lloyd Carr to look at the stop. I mean, Breeze is going to gain yards no matter what happens. Rozelle's going to come right over the middle right here, just like he stopped it earlier in the game.
Down and 5 for the first down, and a timeout though is going to be used as the final seconds tick away on the third quarter. So they'll get a chance to discuss it over on the far side.
Coming up next, true freshman John Standiford makes a big play and gets the Boilermakers right back in the game.
It's a great call out of bounds as Epstein, the regular punter, is also there. And Whitley, they do punt it out of bounds, and it's out at the 5-yard line.
Nice
so
play.
Tough field position.
Yes, it is. And I think Drew Brees says, hey, when we started this half, we were down 28-10. Now at 28-23, I don't care if we have to start the game and start this drive from our end zone. We got the ball with a chance to take the lead.
So Drew Brees. He drove the Boilermakers to scores with their 2 possessions in the third quarter. They have closed to within 5, 28-23. And it's Montrell Lowe behind the
Montrell Lowe, the luck area.
How about that showdown, Michigan Northwestern, 11-7?
In the fourth, that was Rockets who limped off from Michigan as Drew Brees spins out the end zone, fires. Was picked up by Whitley. A dangerous pass over there to Morales, and Whitley had a shot at it.
That time Drew Brees got greedy. He had Sutherland for a nice 5 or 6 yard play. He passed up his first completion trying to get a big completion that time. Watch Sutherland to the outside. He's going to come in and then go back out, and he's wide open on the play. Sutherland comes in, goes back out, throwing the ball. That might be a first down. He goes for the big play and almost gets burned.
Here's the third down that Whitley and the Michigan defense want to stop Brees and Purdue on right here. Third down, and he makes a decent field position out of the pocket. From the end zone, Brees responds. For a moment like Sutherland might hang on, but it was Whitley over there again making a big play off the corner. Whitley having a huge afternoon here for the Wolverines.
Two good plays.
He's been busy.
He really has. And Brent, I wouldn't, you know, I know that was close, but I think that was a good defensive play by Whitley that time. Whitley was right there. Wouldn't really call it a drop ball this time, I don't think. Whitley's right there to jar it loose. Right when it was there, and that's what you want your defenders to do in a passing game.
Now, it looks like they've changed punters.
Well, here's the punt.
Scott Kurz is the punter, not Travis Dorch. That is a huge change this week. This is the first time we've seen the Purdue punt team. And remember, they've botched six of them in the last 3 weeks. Low snap. Penalty flag is down. Bellamy from the 46. Coming up the middle, Bellamy. And Bellamy brings it to the 25-yard line, but there is a penalty flag thrown by the linesman.
Bellamy is going to be a great player before he leaves Michigan. He is fast and fearless, too. Well, Michigan will decline that.
I'd say field position inside the 25-yard line.
Lloyd made a great choice there. A little pooch punt down to the 5, stopped the Boilermakers, and all of a sudden he gets the ball on the 25, first and 10.
Yeah, that was a great decision. You know, I think at first they were probably going to pooch punt Drew Henson.
Yes, I think they were,
because they have done it. They were going to line him up back in the shotgun. Then with the timeout, they said, let's set the long field goal. The wind's now at our back, and maybe we can decoy them that way. And they certainly did. Nobody was back deep, and that play worked for the Wolverines. Now an important drive. You can see the take charge guy, number 7. There's no question about who runs this Michigan Hunter. There is no doubt. And he's 23 of 29 for 232 and 3 touches today. Thomas, they've used him on screens when he's playing. This time they ran away from him, but the fullback Askew. Henry Flagg comes flying.
We're going to get holding now. Sean Phillips was held by the tight end that time, Billy Seymour. Second big mistake by Seymour.
And also, Jonathan Goodwin was irate about the call over here, too, Gary.
Seymour held, though, right at the end of the line. At least one of them. I don't think they can give him more than one penalty, but Seymour held. Yeah, right up at the end, so right off here. I think this is where it happens, right here. Matt Phillips, 20-53. Phillips forces him in, and when he cuts back in, you see the jersey just grabbed, and that's going to be the holding penalty. Field judge has his eyes right on the tight end every time, and they're going to call it facing any jersey just at all wrinkled.
Michigan at the Purdue 35-yard line. First down and 21 for the Wolverines. Drew Henson hits Thomas, and he's to the 23-yard line, almost the original line of scrimmage. Joe Odom making the play defensively here for the Boilermakers. Two fine quarterbacks going toe-to-toe. Right now it's Drew Henson in Michigan. Second down on the drive of Marquise Walker. Short of the first down for the Wolverines. Marquise Walker with 8 catches today for 60 yards. Ralph Turner from Dallas, Texas, makes the stop.
David Terrell is playing now at about 75% capacity. He is saving himself. He's limping out when plays that he's not involved in. Maybe he's saving himself with a little bit of gas he has left to catch a ball, but he is not 100%.
This is 3rd and 2.
Here he is right at the bottom of the screen right there.
Henson looks downfield. Gets rid of it. Incomplete. It's 4th down, and now Michigan will attempt the field goal.
I think they wanted to go to David Terrell deep that time, and he couldn't get down the field. David has to tell his coaches that he's not 100% and come in with somebody else. Here's the fade. Look at Terrell. Cannot run full out. No one to throw to. And had to go off to the side. There it is. Half speed. David needs to get out of the game. Get some salt pills.
The regular holder, John Navarre, is in this time for Jeff Del Verne, who will attempt this field goal for the Wolverines. And Del Verne hits a 34-yarder, and Michigan's lead goes to 8. Timeout.
Coming up next on the Big Ten's Greatest Games.
For the lead.
I was having trouble getting out of bed in the morning because my back hurts so bad.
The sleep.
the Michigan offense. They're going to let him ride this team the rest of the year. He's going to take them as far as they can go. Now Drew Brees comes on, down 8 points with a chance now to tie it again.
Out of the end zone and out on the 20, and we go to Terry Gannon in New York for an NU update. Terry? Just absolutely amazing, and in case you folks did not catch the story, a couple of the coaches at Northwestern, including head coach Randy Walker, are very close to John Matsko of the St. Louis Rams staff. They went down in the spring, and they studied what the St. Louis Rams were doing to attack, and they have used some of that at Northwestern. Obviously, it's working. Here's Drew Brees. Speaking of offense, is working. Sliding, first down, Purdue. Nice, gentlemen, first down and 10. And from the gun, it's Brees. Miller got it. And it's Stratton at the 35-yard line.
He's tucked by an umpire. It's not like he doesn't know there's going to be passes today. Read that one beautifully and just ducked right underneath. Maybe look at this right here. He's going to come up and look at the play, and then he realized he feels it. He's studying my films. I know they like to cross the guys. Duck out of the way and get the completion. That's nice. Good job by Jimmy Herman. You mentioned it before, Brent. Keeping fresh players on the field to rush the passer. Now, sack in the game.
Second and 7, going to run on a slip. And Brees out in front of the other side as Lowe picks up a first down at the 45. College football on ABC, brought to you by Don. Come and see what's different. Burger King, got the urge? Ameritrade, it's how you get somewhere on Wall Street, and Thrifty Car Rental, the car you want, the service you expect, all at a low rate. Just what you want, just Thrifty.
First and 10 at the 44.
Doing a job today also, aren't they? It's this tenacious Wolverine defense that has used a lot of personnel. Here's Brees, Whitley to blitz, pushed out of the way, so it goes deep.
Corner blitz that time, kicked up by the offensive line. And a nice job in the secondary that time. Michigan nowhere to throw the ball.
They had good coverage. Did you hear that down that sideline, guys?
Well-coordinated defense that time. Bring the corner. Dwayne Patman swings across. Covers the receiver, giving Brees nowhere to throw the ball.
I'd like to negotiate the two professional contracts for Brees and Drew Henson.
I think his dad's got one sewed up for one of the guys. He's already locked out.
Second down at 10. Here's the corner blitz. Whitley's coming. He's picked up. And so Brees takes off with the middle. Slides to the hooker. There's a penalty flag for fouling on Anthony Jordan, number 28. Hit Brees after he was sliding. And the officials had blown the play dead, and they thought that Michigan was just a little overly aggressive. And it is a very, very costly penalty here.
It sure was. Good defensive call by Michigan this time. No one open. Drew gets up about 5 or 6 yards, slides, and then there's the hit late, and it's going to be called every time.
Indication against them. And they're going to take that ball inside the 35-yard line. Let's get an update on Terrell. Let's go to Jackaroo.
Well, Gary Danielson, you said that you thought David Terrell needed to come out of the game. Well, he did, but for the reason, he has a problem with his left knee. Actually, his knee has a new knee brace on it. It's one of those rubber braces. In addition to that, he's been trying to stay loosened up by riding a stationary bicycle. He is wounded, but he will go back out.
All right, now Drew Brees for the first down at the 35. Michigan again trying to come with foot. Brees complete. Pitches underneath man Vinny Sutton again. And that plan is being defended by Jeremy Lasur.
Justin Vargas this time, number 34, is in at safety in the football game right now. As Michigan is starting to say, we got a lock on these receivers. We can't let them throw the ball short. Vargas is back playing deep safety. Everyone said he's going to be a future star.
Minutes.
Here he is out, way out to the bottom of the line. He's on his receiver right on the power spot.
He's going to fire quickly. And here comes Sutherland. Got the corner. Out of bounds. At the 16 and a penalty flag. This one could be against Purdue.
Scranton, the tight end, took a block that was 20 yards behind the play. He's going to get a call.
And that will nullify a slick 18-yard gain. Breeze to Sutherland.
First bubble screen I've seen Purdue run in four games. Teams have been taking that play away from the Purdue offense.
Dead ball. Personal foul on the offense. It's a late hit. 15-yard penalty from the end of the run. The offense still made enough yards for a first down. It's still be first down.
That is the first penalty assessed against Purdue today, and it earns the tight end Stratton a spot right next to the head coach. And that might be the worst penalty of all.
This shouldn't be first and 10, though. It should be first and 25, or it should not have been a first down.
First and 10 at the Michigan 30.
The referee is going to miss that.
First and 10 for Purdue. Trailing by 8 points in the fourth quarter. And Montreal Lowe is stuffed at the 30-yard line, bringing second down as Larry Stevens comes in to make the stop with Jack Arut, Gary Danielson. I'm Brett Musburger. We have had a wonderful duel here between Drew Brees and Drew Henson this afternoon. Right now, Brees is attempting to rally the Boilermakers.
Starting the matchup all around the field.
Complete. Tight end makes up for a 10 strike. Earns a first down. This is what Stratton wrote. What for? Over here with Coach Joe Tiller.
Oh, yeah,
and I mean, don't you be doing that, young man, following a play and getting a stupid penalty like that. You understand? We don't tolerate any of that around here, or something to that effect.
Yep. And then perfect read by Drew Brees. He found the one matchup on the field that was a receiver against a linebacker, and that's where he threw it.
15 yards low, tip ties, then dashes to the 10-yard line. Nifty inside move by Lowe.
Brent, I'll tell you what the Purdue players like about Joe Tiller. They don't mind being yelled at like that because he put them back in the game. You know, every player can take that from a coach. It's when you get benched on a play like that that everybody starts to say, oh, man, I don't want to make that critical mistake and lose my job. Joe Tiller will give you an earful, then he puts you back in there and says, go play some football now.
Exactly. 56-14, Oklahoma over Texas. That's the update. Wow.
Go! Go! Oh!
And Lowe out of bounds at the 6-yard line.
Good run by Lowe to force Michigan to take the penalty. Had he been stopped in the backfield, Michigan would have probably declined and made it 3rd and 4. Now they're going to force the Michigan Wolverines into taking a penalty.
We have two fouls in a play. Illegal motion on the offense. Offside on the defense. Both penalties are offset.
All right. So it is 2nd and 3. Purdue trails by 8 points. A touchdown and a two-point conversion. Here's Lowe, and he's swallowed by the middle of the Wolverine defense. Larry Foote, junior inside linebacker, who's very active, number 17, played well last week, then injured his ankle and did not return, but he made a nice stop there.
I thought there was a curious call, 2nd and medium that time. Michigan loves when Purdue lines up with two tight ends and runs the ball. They're used to running that defense. They need to spread and expose this Michigan defense out.
You can see how we've had two dandy rushers today, Thomas and Lowe, both averaging over 16 yards. 3rd down and 3.
Michigan's going to blitz here.
And Breeze over the middle has the freshman touchdown. What a two-point conversion away as John Standifer dashes into the end zone for Joe Tiller's offense. But now a critical two-point conversion.
Right, I think you'll see again why I do not like going for two early in the game. Had they kicked the extra point earlier, out, puts it into the end zone.
Individually, face to face, he told them, gentlemen, it is time. It was Drew Henson, not Drew Brees, but played with intensity. He says, you've got to play like it's tied, as you said, Gary. He said, you've got to play the best series that you've played all day.
All right, Jack. The battle of the Drews continues here. Second down and five. Because of the play by Ron Turner.
Ron Turner came to Purdue as a quarterback, moved over to safety, one of the two strong safety in the game, along with Stuart Swigert, the free safety, right off the edge this time, right over there making the play. Askew makes his only mistake of the game. He misses the strong safety and runs right by him to get no play on end play. DJ Askew, that's his man.
Third down and 11 for Henson. He's 26 of 33 for 256 yards. Middle almost intercepted by Adele. Aiken Adele from Irving, Texas. Drop back and a shot at him. Couldn't hang on.
Aiken Adele is a defensive end. That's why Drew Brees never saw him on the play. He's usually rushing the passer. Adele had 11 sacks last year, the most on Purdue's team, dropping in coverage.
Now Hayden Epstein standing on the Michigan goal. Vinny Sutherland. Midfield. Landing to his own man who couldn't get through the defensive player, and he's down at the 48-yard line. The best starting field position today for Purdue and quarterback Drew Brees.
Look at the difference in style for Michigan. They've decided we're not going to give you the gimme throws. They're coming up on everybody.
Brees takes it long, and the first one can't hang on. Standing for just off his fingertips. Patlin, the defender, as you take a look at Purdue with all three of its timeouts, just like Michigan. Dorsch, the field goal specialist, has kicked a 47-yarder. Third down conversion, Brees and Purdue, 12-14. They have now thrown 35 times and completed 26 for 242 yards. And there is Travis Dorsch staying warm here on the near side. Purdue side. Second down. Michigan with four down defensive linemen, and Brees takes off. First down across the 35-yard line. A 14-yard run for the Purdue quarterback.
No time to think about safety now. Two-point game against Michigan. You've never beat these guys. This was a called play, a quarterback draw all the way, and Drew Brees says, says, I can't worry about being healthy. I'm going for it. He got popped pretty good. I watched him coming up and flexing his arm as he got up, but he had to have the first back.
Almost 900 total yards here today. 469 to 431. It has been a great offensive show. Sutherland's number 14 to have a lead. Breeze right. Seth Morales and Todd Howard, the defender there.
I think Michigan's defense and Jimmy Herman has now kind of figured it out. He said, we can't give Breeze easy throws. Maybe we don't feel comfortable playing bump and run. Maybe we don't have the athletes like Penn State or Ohio State does to jam them all over the field in the secondary. But we have to do it. It's the only way to stop the offense is to come up and come after the receiver. If you lay back, Breeze is just too accurate. He'll pick your part. Michigan up in the faces of the Purdue receiver.
4:18 now. Breeze fires, and that time he got the man in the middle across the 30-yard line. So he will leave Purdue with third and short. That was Stratton, the tight end. And Stratton here today with 9 catches for 68 yards. Sutherland has 9 catches for 112 yards.
Joe Tiller has to start thinking ahead now. They don't get the first down. Do you use the field goal attempt now? Remember, a miss by Dorsch last week against Penn State. That's what Joe Tiller right now is thinking. If you don't make it, you got to think ahead. That's your strategy.
A little breeze would be blowing against Dorsch if they do try it here. Third down and 5 for the Panthers. Here comes the blitz. He's got his man, and he's got the first down. Inside the 20-yard line, John Stanford has become the go-to guy, 11 yards.
Very subtle part of the offense in this Joe Tiller offense is to use the umpire as a little bit of a pick. Here comes the receiver in. Now watch the umpire cut right underneath them, and that forces the defender to go behind. It's a little bit of a angle that this offense can use in those short yard situations.
Now, Montrell Lowe is going to dandy running back today for 117 yards back in the game with the ball in the red zone for Purdue. Here comes Lowe. There's his specialty. And he runs it to the 10-yard line. It'll be second and short. And we have time permitted, the thrifty Arlen post-game report with our pair of Terrys, Terry Gannon and Terry Bowden. Back in New York, they'll have all the big stories. Northwestern doing it again. Oklahoma says, we can't wait to get to Manhattan. Kansas, that is. And we will be there, Gary and I, for Oklahoma, Kansas State. Right now, we've got a great one here in West Lafayette. Second down and 2. Here's Lowe. By foot. What a great stop that was by the Michigan linebacker here on second down.
Michigan should start using their timeouts now. They need to look at, there's probably going to be a field goal, and they have taken a timeout. Very good call by Lloyd Carr.
And again, they shift Stratton in for extra protection. Quick fire on the slants, incomplete on Morales, and the pass was high. And here comes Travis Gorsch.
One of the poor throws Drew Brees has thrown all game behind the receiver and high.
Now, Dorsch made a 24-yarder way back in the first quarter. That concluded Purdue's first drive after a would-be touchdown pass was dropped in the back of the end zone. This will be a 32-yard attempt by the young man from Montana, whose holder is Ben Smith. For the lead. Hold it. No go. So Travis Dorsch misses the 32-yarder, and Michigan holds a 31-29 lead. 2:11 left on the clock.
When he missed that, I thought, well, obviously, you got to rally and find a way to get the ball back and give us at least another chance.
I know this, that when it came down to two-minute offense, as a staff, we were very relieved because we had Drew Brees.
I tried to think very positively still that, hey, we're still going to have a chance and we got to be ready when we get the ball back.
Here, and the kick was bad. Snap was a little low. Holder did a good job on it, but then Dorsch kind of felt that pressure and pulled it wide, and no one has gone up to him yet. And he may get it back again. Purdue has two timeouts left.
So Michigan, first and 10. Coming out from the 20-yard line, Thomas is stuffed. And the linesman says timeout, and again it is a kicking problem that has come back to haunt Purdue. Nobody lonelier in the world right now than that young man. Second down and 9.
Has to keep his head in it. Might get another shot. No, at the end of that drive, Brandon, it wasn't just a kicker either. Remember, it was 3rd and a yard. They jump off sides, and then Drew Brees throws an inaccurate pass to force the field goal. Kind of a meltdown by the Boilermakers when they had the game ready to be put away.
Bellamy's in motion. Hits it, gives it to him, and he's stuck, but breaks the tackle, and then can't get back to the line of scrimmage. Ralph Turner.
The delay of game. 3 critical mistakes, and they had a chance to fake the game, a 1-point lead.
But you know what? It's not over.
Oh, no.
They stopped Michigan on 2 plays. Here comes a 3rd down. And remember, Brees and Purdue can stop the clock, unlike the NFL, on 1st down.
Yes. Purdue has no timeouts remaining in the game. I don't know. What do you do? You're Lloyd Carr, you got to think. You're on your own 19-yard line. You've got a great talented quarterback. Do you put it in the air? I think you have to.
He's thinking about it. We'll be right back. Back and forth we go with these two coaches, Lloyd Carr and Joe Taylor, with decisions to make. And Lloyd has to decide, does he gamble or does he keep it on the ground, keep the clock moving? Keep the clock moving and cut it. And you're right. Hits it on the rear. Fires high. That stops the clock.
I was just writing the call. I don't know if the strategy was right. Funny type of a call on 3rd down. I would have just rather had Drew Henson drop back and throw the ball. It would have been my preference.
Clock is stopped. 1:52 now. Epstein to punt. Sutherland. He's a nifty return guy. So it is up to the Gunners from Michigan
now
to
Travis,
get downfield.
Now Travis puts his helmet back on.
They get a second chance. High punt by Epstein. Good one. Sutherland to the 40. Drew Brees and Purdue are 60 yards away. 1:41. They're out of timeouts. Only 1st downs to stop the clock. Larry Foote comes down for the punt team that time and makes the play. What a fine player he is.
So eerie talking to Drew Brees yesterday and Joe Tiller about tight football games. Joe was very honest when he said, I just don't think our guys are comfortable in tight games. He said, let it go. We should be comfortable in these games. A chance to beat Michigan in the 4th quarter with 2 minutes to go. We should revel in that opportunity, and he has it.
Cuts back away and slides toward the 1st down.
Michigan did a good job of keeping him from a 1st down, though.
I'm not sure they did, Gary. The clock has stopped. It's very close. They're moving the chains. That's a 1st down. That's why they stopped at 1:32 now. And the 49-yard line.
Receivers have plays on their wrist. They're checking them. He's calling them by number.
Good blocking, good protection. Got to stop the clock, and he does. He was out of pocket.
Gary looked back and nobody was open, Gary.
Yes, since Michigan has changed their tactics and strategy in this game, they've bottled up the Purdue pass offense just like Penn State and Notre Dame has. The receivers aren't open, and Drew Brees, with plenty of time to throw, is not finding easy throws now.
There's a second down in. 10 coming up for Purdue. 119. These other games will be starting just as soon as we run off this 119.
From the 48.
Sit down and enjoy this one, huh?
Now Brees, middle. Complete, but not a first down. Brees Cox going to continue to run, and Purdue's got to hurry. Purdue's got to hurry because A.T. Simpson did not get a first down on the reception. They need about a yard, and the clock is down to about 1 minute. Now Brees waits. There's the first down, and the clock is stopped with 53 seconds to go as he comes to Standiford on the sideline.
How about that one? Come to the true freshman in a critical throw of the game. Puts it right there for the first down and 53 seconds. Plenty of time. But if you're Drew Brees or Joe Tiller, I think you got to start thinking touchdown here now. You can't just say Dorsch is going to kick the field goal. That's not a gimme. The guy's got something wrong with the right part of the team. That's it right.
Here's Brees, sideline, Sutherland stopped the clock at the 31-yard line. 50 seconds to go, and Travis Dorsch over there, conversation with the coach, one of two today, just missed the 32-yarder, made it 24 earlier, that was way back in the first quarter.
Remember, it's got to be tough on his head, he missed last week against Penn State.
Second down, 5 at the 31.
Second down, 5, the guy at the rim. Here's Brees, stands tall, got the first down and stopped the clock. Sutherland at the 21-yard line, 45 seconds.
They're grounded.
And he may have caught the 12th man.
Absolutely.
He caught the 12th man. That was the flag.
Absolutely.
I believe it. And Drew Brees saw him trying to get off the field, and he quickly sent it down. There were too many men on the snap. He caught him before he got off.
He did. Michigan tried to change it. You know what? Purdue had 12 men on the field, too, because Joe Tiller was out to the numbers pointing it out. Joe was running out there saying they had 12 men out there. Michigan gambled, tried to change their personnel on first down, and they got burned.
On a defense. Player in yard.
Here they go, trying to leave the field right there. They never got out of the snap.
The clock on loop. Gary Danielson, I'm Brett Musburger. Final 44 seconds of Purdue, Michigan. Purdue trailing it by 2 points, driving on Michigan. This is a 1st and 5 after the penalty at the 17-yard line. Here's Lowe on the run. Doing. They don't get the first down. Clock runs.
They're going to have
Anthony Jordan. They got out this clock.
They're going to ground it and kick the field goal. They tried to run the ball to the right that time, and Lowe cut back. Officials will clean it up, and then they'll start the clock. And Michigan takes the timeout. Very, very smart.
So 23 seconds, and you just imagine the thoughts in this young man's head, but at least he said, I'm getting a second chance. That's all you can ask for in this situation is a second chance, and he's about to get it.
If you're Joe Tiller, you can't take the gamble that you can run the ball and get off 2 plays. You wonder right now if you might kick it now or throw the ball into the end zone might be the other strategy.
I want to go back to that last snap. I'm surprised they tried right there.
I think they tried to center it in the middle of the field for the field goal, and then they were going to ground it, and he went the wrong way. Let's look at the last one by Travis Dorsch right here. Snap slightly low. The holder leans it, I think, the wrong direction. He leans it out towards the kicker, which produces a hook type of a live line like that. misses it left. It's exactly why you're supposed to pull the ball to you if you're a holder.
Ben Smith is his holder. We'll have a few nerves right now, too, won't he? So we have 23 seconds left, and it is second down, so it is still time for Breeze to take a shot downfield.
Yeah, or center the ball on a run and come up and bounce the ball like the other side.
So here's Breeze under center. He's going to center on himself, but now they're going to stop the clock.
They'll be fine. Line up, drop the ball. Shouldn't give any time. Drew Breeze should run it down to 3 seconds. You don't want Drew Henson with time.
They don't have much time.
That's right.
And here they come. A second chance.
Not many people get a mulligan in the same game.
Just about the same distance, maybe a yard longer, folks. This looks like it's going to be about 33. As Michigan wants to apply a little ice and talk about it. And, of course, we'll be going to these games, Ohio State, Wisconsin, Nebraska, Iowa State, North Carolina State, Clemson, which should be a great one, Arizona, USC, the loneliness of Travis Moore.
Yeah. Think about Drew Brees. He's never beat Ohio State. He's never beat Wisconsin. He's never beaten Michigan. He's got a chance with a kick to win a game and stay alive in the Big Ten championship run. He said to us yesterday, Brent, if we run the table, we're going to win it. He's right.
We opened the day talking about the kicking game problem here. And now we come to an end, and it will be a kicking situation. And it looks like Timmy Stratton is bending over the ball to snap it. Ben Smith, the holder. And here comes Travis Walsh, officially 33 yards. You'll get a perfect view of it on the end zone camera. This time he's good. So Travis Walsh. 32-31 with 4 seconds left on the clock.
If Drew Brees would have lost one more yard, it would not have been good. It was moving out of the goalpost area. In fact, the Michigan defenders thought he missed it. It was very close. He hooks it, but not as bad. Sneaks it inside there. I think. I can't tell. Can't get depth on it, but you got to trust the official was right there.
Purdue would go on to be co-Big Ten champions and play their first Rose Bowl in 34 years. While Drew Brees would finish third in the Heisman Trophy voting. Michigan would finish 9-3, beating Auburn in the Florida Citrus Bowl. That's all for this edition of the Big Ten's Greatest Games. We'll see you next time.